Learn and apply the formulas for lateral area and surface area of a prism and cylinder.
What's the difference between lateral area and surface area?
Well, in order to explain the difference, let's review some characteristics for both a prism and a cylinder. In a prism, the bases are congruent figures in parallel planes. The lateral faces are the faces that are not bases. In a right prism, these lateral faces are rectangles. Two lateral faces intersect at a lateral edge. In a right prism, lateral edges are altitudes since they are perpendicular to the bases. These definitions are similar for a cylinder. The bases are congruent circles in parallel planes. While there are no lateral faces, the lateral surface is the curved surface between the two bases. The axis of a cylinder is the segment whose endpoints are the centers of the bases. If the axis is perpendicular to the bases, then the cylinder is a right cylinder. So the lateral area of a prism is the sum of the areas of all the lateral faces. For a cylinder, it is the area of the lateral surface. The total surface area of a right prism or cylinder is the lateral area plus the area of the two bases.
Is there a formula to help calculate the lateral area and surface area?
Yes. There are general formulas for both right prisms and cylinders. To determine what those are, look at the net of each figure. The lateral area is the area of the large rectangles for both the prism and cylinder. For the prism, the length of this rectangle is the perimeter of the base. So the lateral area of this right prism is the length of the rectangle, A plus B plus C, times the height. Or simply, the perimeter of the base, P, times the height of the prism, H. Likewise for the cylinder, the length of this rectangle is the circumference of the base. So the lateral area of the cylinder is the circumference of the base times the height, or 2 times pi times the radius times the height. To find the total surface area for each figure, simply add the area of the two bases to the lateral area.
For the prism, will the formula change if the base is not a triangle?
Let's look at a hexagonal prism. If we unfold this prism to create its net, the length of the rectangle is still the perimeter of the base. This will be true no matter what the shape of the base. So the lateral area of a right prism is always the perimeter of the base times the height. The surface area is dependent on the lateral area and the area of the base. Thus, the base can change size and shape, but we need only one formula.
Would you do a couple of examples?
Sure. Here we want to find the lateral area of the cylinder. Substitute the values for the radius and height into the formula for the lateral area. The result is 600 pi, or approximately 1,885 centimeters squared. In this problem, find the surface area of the triangular prism. To calculate surface area, we need the perimeter of the base, the height of the prism, and the area of the base. The base of this prism is a triangle, so that area formula is 1/2 base times height. Be careful here. There are now two different heights in this formula. One is the height of the prism, 8, and the other is the height of the triangle, 12. When we substitute these values, the total surface area is 300 square units.